students, let's start with the professional ethics inside unit number 5. Last topic of unit number 5 of individual factor is individual factor in business ethics. Okay,
in fact, white collar crime. Okay, start understanding with the personal ethics. So what do you mean by personal ethics? Okay, so in fact, personal ethics includes your personal and moral qualities. Okay, your personal values and moral qualities influenced by family, friends, culture, religion, education, and many other factors. Okay, so in that personal values or personal ethics, example of the personal ethics, I believe racism is morally wrong. Okay, so I am in favor of abortion. So personal ethics can change and are chosen by an individual.
Next one is the common ethics. So in that common ethics, what do you mean by common ethics? So ethics that the majority of people agree on any decision or any particular decision. Okay, so many philosophers argue this is no such ethics. This type of is not an ethics. Okay, but question is that do we have the same ethics in the world? Do we have the same ethics in the US? Does everyone in your family share the same ethics? Right? Example, murdering people for the sake of the murder is wrong. Okay? Notice how his mood changed in the context of self-defense. Right? And the common ethics have to be very general to avoid the disagreement. Okay? So, this type of ethics is a common ethics. The next one is professional ethics. So, in that professional ethics rules impose an employee in the company or as a member of a profession. For instance, journalist, doctor, lawyer, etc. Right? So, imposed when you are a part of a professional setting or when you are being trained or educated for a working for a specific profession. For example, no gossiping, time management, punctuality, confidentiality, and transparency. These all are the values and the example of the professional ethics. Okay, so professional ethics is the one type of the rule of the any company which we have the any employee in this company. Not adhering to this may harm your professional reputation. Okay, same type professional ethics. No adhering to this may harm your professional reputation. Right? The next one is meta-ethics, normative ethics, and applied ethics. This three types of ethics is very important in our ethics. Okay? So, let's understand of the meta-ethics, normative ethics, and applied ethics. So, what do you mean by meta-ethics? Okay, so in that meta-ethics concerning the theoretical meaning and reference of moral proportions and how their truth value, if any value, right, can be determined. Okay, so consists in the attempt to answer the fundamental philosophical questions about the nature of the ethical theory itself. It's called the meta-ethics. Okay, so let's see the example of the meta-ethics. If we could prove the inferences and provide proof, then the woman makes better parent than a man. For example, if this was a fact, okay, then we could argue that the man should not be a single parent. It is the moral judgment, right? So this is the example of the meta-ethics. The next one is the normative ethics. So what do you mean by normative ethics? Concerning the practical means of the determining the moral courses of action. Any type of the action, right? It is considered as a normative ethics. Practical means determining moral courses, okay? These all are about the normative ethics. So normative ethics is the study of what make action right or wrong, okay? What make situation or event is good or bad, right? And what makes people or what makes the people virtuous or is vicious, okay? So these all are about the normative ethics, and we will see the example of the normative ethics about Locke's crucial theory of the social contract. This is the example of the normative ethics. Then Kant's normative ethics, then utilitarian normative ethics, John Travell's theory of justice, okay, Jürgen Habermas's ethics of the argumentation. These all are the example of the normative ethics. Okay, the next, the third one is the applied ethics. So concerning what a person is obligated or permitted to do in a specific situation or a particular domain of action. Okay, so example of the applied ethics is the abortion, capital punishment, war, and animal rights. These all are the example of the applied ethics. Okay, and these all are the controversial issues, right? Next, individual factors. So how many types of the individual factors? Which type of the individual factor? Okay, so let's see the individual factor means birth factor, and this is the experience factor, right? So first one is age, gender, nationality, and culture. These all are the individual factors. Then education, personality, okay, then psychological functions and the moral imagination. These all are the individual factors. Okay, so let's see the individual factor, personal factor or individual factor, both are same. Income, age, lifestyle and occupation. These all are the individual factor. Okay, so let's starting with the age. First one is age. The consumer buying behavior is greatly influenced by his age. For example, the lifestyle stage is which he follows. The people buy different products in different stages of the lifestyle. Okay, different person have a different lifestyle, right? With respect to age, okay, so such as the purchase of the chocolate is more when an individual is child and he has grown, his preference for the product also change, right? So product purchasing is changed by change over the age. Second one is income. So the income of the person includes his buying pattern. Then the income decides the purchasing power of an individual, and thus the more the person income, the more will be the expenditure on other items and vice versa. Okay, so income is the influence is buying the pattern, right? Then third one is occupation. The occupation of the individual also includes his buying behavior. Okay, which type of occupation? Okay, teacher, engineer, doctor, which type of occupation? Okay, so this is depends on the occupation also. The people tend to buy those products and services and advocate their profession and role in this society. For example, the buying pattern of the lawyer will be different from the other groups of the people, such as the normal people, doctor, teacher, businessman, etc. Right? So buying pattern will be different from the occupation. Okay, so depend on occupation, buying pattern will be also different. Then fourth one is lifestyle. The consumer buying behavior is influenced by his lifestyle. Right? The lifestyle means individual interest, which type of interest, personal interest, right? Values, opinions, activities reflect the manner in which he lands in the society. Okay, such as if the person has a healthy lifestyle, then he will avoid the junk food and consume more and more organic products. Okay, so depends on individual or person. So lifestyle is individual or depends on personal morals or the thinking power, right? And the last factor is cultural factor. So it is believed that an individual learns the set of the values, perceptions, behaviors and preference at a very early stage of his childhood from the people, especially the family and the other institutions which were around during the development of the state of any person, right? So this is the last factor of the individual factor. And now over here, over the chapter number 5, okay? So in the next session, we will start with this last chapter, is professional ethics in the chapter number 6.